sugar, spice, and everything nice. These were the ingredients chosen to create the perfect little girl. But Professor Utonium accidentally added an extra ingredient to the concoction. Chemical X. Thus, the Powerpuff Girls were born! Using their ultra superpowers, Blossom, Bubbles, and Buttercup have dedicated their lives to fighting crime and the forces of evil!
The City of Townsville, a succinct city where simple questions are given simple answers.
Guilty. What? I object, which is to say that I do not agree with that it is that you say, which is incorrect, lacking in proper knowledge of the truth, and wrong. Furthermore, order! Due to your obvious failure for rehabilitation, I have decided that the best form of punishment is for you to give back to the community from which you have taken so much.
Must I pick up garbage?
You, Mojo Jojo, are hereby sentenced to teaching a knowledge extension course at Townsville Community College. No!
By which I mean I cannot do it.
Hello and good evening to you. I am Mojo Jojo, your instructor, and the person who will be teaching you from this point forward. That is to say, that as you are here representing the students of the class, I am here representing the teacher of the class. And as it is my job to teach, it is your job to learn, and in learning, gain more intelligence than you currently have. Now, what are the names or individual identifications that have been assigned to the lot of you?
Denny,
Italia,
Enrique,
Nadia,
Ernst,
Min,
Haruk.
I see. Now, as teacher and thus assigner of the grades in this class, if I were to be performing said grading right now at this moment, let me tell you that none of you passed. That is right. In the grading system, I would have assigned you all with an F, which if I had control of the grading system, I would make the lowest grade a Z, since that is the final letter in the alphabet which starts with A and ends with Z. But instead, the letter given for those who do most poorly is an F, seeing as it goes A, B, C, D, F, with the inexplicable skipping of E. Nonetheless, after that pathetic display, all of you would get an F, symbolizing failure for your poor use of English.
Pardon, monsieur, but all you did was ask of us our names, and that is what we answered with?
Yes, and that is wrong, because it is boring and uninteresting. And thoroughly bringing me about to a state of unconsciousness. From those simple, pathetic names, I learn nothing. I am here to teach you proper English, and with that, you are to learn proper descriptive and defining skills. Let us try this again. Tell me your names.
My name is Philippe, which is to say that upon my birth, my parents Jean-Paul and Camille place upon me this title which identifies me as me and separates me from all the others?
Excellent! Next!
See, I am called Italia, after my Aunt Tali, which is shorter and more, casual version of Talia, often referred to as a nickname, which is a term of endearment and some...
And while Haruk does not trip off the tongue lightly, it is a name of substance and vigor for which I am proud and take much pride.
Yes, yes, yes! Now that was some speaking, and what was spoken well. Class dismissed.
Is the class which seemed to just start really over? As in done?
Yes, the 2 hours allotted as time for class is now finished, and the time for leaving has now begun. See you tomorrow, which is the day that will begin after the passing of tonight's midnight hour.
The City of Townsville, a succinct city where simple questions are given simple answers, except for... What's this?
What kind of a simple question is that to ask of the woman to whom you wish to enter the state of matrimony? Your question lacks the complexity and weight that is apropos of such a complex and weighty matters, and thus makes me question your true heartfelt feelings in this serious life decision.
ketchup or mustard?
Do you mean would I prefer the sweet fluid tomato flavorings or the smashed liquefied mustard seed renderings enjoyed by most consumers upon the hottest of dogs?
Yeah. Is that dog which you hold within the embrace of your arms also held within your ownership? By which I mean, are you the sole caregiver for this pooch that is within your personal grasp? In other words, is that your schnauzer?
No. It's my cat in a dog suit.
Well, then let me tell you.
If that is your simple and plainly painfully boring answer,
then you are in need of being re-educated by
Mojo Jojo.
Why is my class, which was previously merely a few people, now more than a few, which equals many?
Because in our speaking of proper English around Townsville, Sir Mojo, it became clear to those previously in the dark that their English was inaccurate, that they must enter the light except in that it is in the hearing, not in the seeing, that this light has come upon them.
Ah, yes, good. I see. So now it begins, starts, and comes to commencement. To the masses I must now reach, and in the reaching, these classroom walls cannot confine my unending grasp.
Yes, ma'am? What? Yes, but where?
There is a stealing of sorts happening at the place where money is given and taken. That is to say, deposited and withdrawn, and sometimes redistributed and loaned. But currently, the taker is taking that which is not his, thus performing an act of illegality, which could result in incarceration within the confines of a penal facility, that is to say, prison, jail, hoosegow, etc.
What's he saying?
I have no idea, but I think something bad is happening.
Let's go!
Look! I don't believe it! The town's at a complete standstill.
But why?
Is there an accident?
All I see is that cop and that old lady.
Let's check it out.
You realize that you were walking in the crosswalk after the green walking man had stopped being displayed and when the flashing red hand had become the prominent visual.
And while I appreciate the change in the crosswalk signage, the fact of the matter is, I am of elderly persuasion, and due to the deterioration calcium level in my bones, my pedestrian abilities, which is to say my walking, is of a much slower pace than the average citizen of Downsville.
Is this a crime?
No, just annoying.
Maybe the mayor was trying to tell you about a bank robbery.
To the bank!
The amount which I want to withdraw is not that from any bank account which I hold within a bank. In other words, I wish to take money that does not belong to me, but is instead in the ownership of others who have worked hard to gather funds for their future rainy days.
But what I am asking you is, do you have an account which I can access? And if so, what are the numerical digits for me to properly type upon the keyboard to tap into the computer system which allows me permission into all of the fund-related requests?
And what you are failing to understand is that I do not have said account, since I am not a patron of this fine establishment, except to take from it that which is not mine.
Is this a stick-up?
Seems more like a stuck-up.
What the heck is going on here?
And so I, Mojo Jojo, impart upon you the empowerment of Mo-Linguish.
Mo-Linguish?
There's the crime.
And with this power, you will no longer speak in brief, boring, abbreviated sentences, but instead will wow the crowds with your scintillating usage of an overabundance of nouns, verbs, adjectives, pronouns, prepositions, and of course the conjunction junctions, which have a multiple of functions. With the skill of Mo-Linguish, the world, which was previously not yours to be taken, will be at your fingertips.
That's it!
He's done it!
Mojo has managed to bring Townsville to a complete standstill by having all of the people speak in the most lengthy of questions and redundant of answers! Thus, nothing can be asked or answered without the verbosity of words, causing the city to come to a permanent and most painful halt! Furthermore,
bubbles!
Sorry! We've got to reprogram Townsville, bringing their speech patterns back to normal. Come on! Ma'am? Officer? All this can be solved by you briefly stating your point and moving on.
But if I were to speak briefly, it would mean that I did not speak all that I wished to have spoken, meaning that I would not fully express myself to the fullest and thus spoken in too small of a sentence to properly satisfy.
And if I simply said yes or no, the reasonings behind that yes or no would be unheard and unvoiced and unpontificated, thus leaving me with a feeling of stifled combustion that would be ready to explode.
No, this isn't going to work!
Certainly not. If our wishes to remedy the situation which is currently lacking closure...
Bubbles!
Someone has to reteach them.
But do we know whose English is good enough to reverse the effects of Mo-Linguish and retrain all these people to speak properly, thus eliminating the circular pattern in which they are speaking? Darn it! Now I'm doing it!
I can think of only one in Townsville who has that power.
Now repeat after me. The color of the sky is...
blue.
The color of the grass is
green.
The stop sign on the street is
red.
Very good. Now let's move on to numbers. A dozen is
12.
Well, this is going well.
Do you think Mojo is really learning his lesson?
Oh, I think he's learning quite a bit.
The Easter Bunny hides
eggs, which are generally regular eggs which have been boiled in the hottest of water and then decorated in a vinegar-based dye by placing... Ow!
Keep it brief, buddy.
Eggs.
And so, once again, the day is saved, because it was the day that was in need of being saved due to the previously unsaved nature of the day. Thanks and in most humble gratitude, and that is saying in much appreciation to the Powerpuff Girls.
Enough already!
Sorry, my most humble apologies. Please forgive me. As the narrator, that is to say, teller of the story, I feel like I must provide a snappy button, that is a concluding phrase, to each one of your action-packed adventures.
Quiet!
The city of Townsville, where it is a beautiful sunny day, and there's not a sign of trouble on the...
The city of Townsville, a city that, while being a city, is for some inexplicable reason called town. And not only is it called a town, but also a ville, thus making it a city, town, and village, which seems to me to be redundant and repetitive, which can be quite annoying if you ask me, which you have no choice but to do, for now I, Mojo Jojo, am in charge of the city of Townsville, where it is beautiful and sunny, and frankly, I'm tired of it. So I say instead, the city of Townsville, where it is a little overcast, thus cutting down on the incessant heat wave we've been having. And in the outskirts of this city, Townville, whatever, at the Utonium Chateau, there are three little girls, Blossom, Bubbles, and Buttercup.
Gee, the weather sure did change suddenly.
And though they thought they would be spending a peaceful day at home, they hurriedly head for the city to do my bidding.
For some strange reason, I feel compelled to go into the city.
I know what you mean. Let's go.
As they head out, they pass by their father of sorts, Professor Utonium.
Hi, girls. Look what I just dug up from the garage. It's my old pseudo-subatomic quasar debabbler. It picks up intergalactic radio waves from distant stars and decodes them into crackles and pops. Oh, the hours we would sit there enthralled by the sounds of cosmic static.
Blah, 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 blah. I grow tired of Professor Utonium's endless banter. And as I grow tired of it, so do the Powerpuff Girls, for I am in control.
Is that all, Professor? We're kind of in a hurry.
Well, I just thought I'd share a bit of Utonium history with you.
Ah, shut up! What just happened there?
I think you just dissed the professor.
Something's wrong here.
Don't want to keep you girls from any important business.
I'm sorry, Professor. We're just in a real hurry to get into town.
Oh, don't mention it. I understand. Why, I remember when the premiere issue of Extreme Chemical Physics came out. Why, I was so anxious to get a copy, is the latest issue out already?
As the girls head to the city in a hurried manner, they... Wait a minute. Hold up.
Oh, I can't wait to give this baby a whirl.
And to the professor, they each give a swift kick. Why? Because I don't like him. No, not one bit.
Maybe I should curb their sugar intake.
And off those girls fly to the city. No, walk!
Was it to walk anyway? Anyone can see these feet aren't designed for walking.
At least it's not raining.
That's not a bad idea. And so the Powerpuff Girls steal mini jewels to my liking, meaning the most expensive ones which contain the topmost quality and clarity.
Nice.
Then they head to the bank.
You're welcome.
And next, it is off to the museum where, hold up, while flying past Townsville Hall, the girls stop in and give that mayor a swift kick as well.
Powerpuff Girls, to what do I owe the pleasure? Pow! Hey, there's my Mr. Pickle action figure. I was looking all over for that. Thanks, Powerpuff Girls. Oh, Mr. Pickle.
Then off to the museum, where fine art is procured. The finer, the better. Finally, with the bag full of loot, the girls head straight for the lair of that most ingenious, brilliant, and amazingly smart Mojo Jojo. Upon arriving, the girls do not crash through the ceiling, which has cost the owner of said lair innumerable dollars. But go through the front door. And they wipe their feet. Yes.
Buttercup, I don't think that bag of booty's gonna fit through that doorway.
Oh, you betcha it will.
Carefully, they put the booty in their designated places where they are supposed to be put. And without further ado, they destroy each other. I amend that they carefully destroy each other without further harming the area in which they are destroying each other in. Hello? Testing, testing. Control-Alt-Delete! Pay no attention to that monkey behind the curtain.
Destroy each other. Hey, go home.
In the stomach or in the face?
How about an option of the third type?
Not the face!
Something's wrong here.
Yeah, we beat up Mojo.
And saved the day.
But it doesn't feel right. It feels like
something's missing.
Yeah. But what?
Hey, girls, look!
Ow! Oh, girls, thank goodness it's you! I can finally end this nightmare! So, once again, the day is saved, thanks to the Powerpuff Girls!
Something was missing.
Yep.
Good night, folks. Now what?
Could I get a lift home?
Of course.
Sugar. Spice. And everything nice. These were the ingredients chosen to create the perfect little girl. But Professor Utonium accidentally added an extra ingredient to the concoction. Chemical X. Thus, the Powerpuff Girls were born! Using their ultra-superpowers, Blossom, Bubbles, and Buttercup have dedicated their lives to fighting crime and the forces of evil! Where it's a petty world out there and petty crime is at an all-time high. Which leads us to the question of who could be picking the pockets of the unsuspecting citizens of Townsville?
Why, me, of course.
Who said that?
Down here.
You?
Yes, me. Madame Argentina, psychic medium, and just plain all-around baddie. And this is my sidekick, Fred.
Hello.
Well, it looks as if the profits aren't enough for this prophet. She's using fortune-telling to take fortunes.
Ain't I a stinker?
I think Philanthropist, the wealthy charitable donor, would agree with that. And Sosumi Blind, the famous Japanese lawyer, would too. Not to mention Mr. Polarfield, the magnet magnate. For these are but a few of Townsville citizens who've been robbed by this elusive and rather vertically challenged psychic, which is why the newspapers this day read, small, medium, at large.
And which is why I have to constantly relocate. Oh, they'll never find me on the outskirts of town. Now, if you'll excuse me, I am expecting a client for a 4 o'clock appointment.
Oh no, it's the mayor of Townsville. The one person who should have read the newspaper today, but didn't.
Please sit, I have been expecting you.
Wow, you are good.
I am sensing presence of a dead relative.
Yes, yes, I do have dead relatives.
A dead aunt?
Yes, yes, I have one of those. Uncanny.
Yes, it is your dead aunt coming through. Aunt,
Gertrude? My dead aunt Gertrude?
That's the one.
Yes, she wants to speak to me. How you doing, Gert?
Having been lulled into a false sense of security by Madame Argentina's false sense of fortune-tellery, let's take a gander at that goose. Shh. Trained in the high art of pocket pickery, Madame Argentina's trusty sidekick Fred is able to pull valuables straight from the pockets of her unsuspecting clients. Meanwhile...
Wow! That was amazing! However do you do it?
A good medium never reveals her secrets.
I thought that was a musician.
Whatever. $10, please.
Keep the change.
And with that, the mayor leaves his session impressed, albeit lighter than when he came in. But when the mayor reached the gates, he realized that he was missing his key. And not just any key, but the key to the city. And as the mayor turned back to reclaim his property, he found that Madame Argentina and Fred had fled, thus leaving the mayor locked out of Townsville.
Again.
Here we are, outside the household of one Professor Utonium, creator and father to that crime-fighting trio, the Powerpuff Girls, who at this very moment receive an urgent call from the mayor.
What is it, Mayor? Again? And you've been locked out since Wednesday, but Mayor, it's Saturday. Why did you wait so long to call?
My cell phone calling plan has free weekend minutes.
And with that, the girls were off, faster than you could say, Professor Utonium.
Professor Utonium?
We're here, Mayor.
Well, I'll be. I couldn't finish saying it.
And so the mayor laid out the sordid details of his predicament.
Wait. Let me get this straight. You asked a psychic for decisions on municipal issues?
Oh, no, of course not. That would be silly. I got advice from a dead relative.
Regardless of how the mayor handles his civic duties, the girls still had a job to do. And with that, they were off faster than you could say bad television.
Bad television.
Later, Mayor.
Darn it.
And so the girls flew from psychic to psychic without any luck. And a short time later, regrouped at the mayor's office to discuss the situation.
It's just no use. There must be thousands of short psychic women in Townsville.
Bubbles is right. One could throw a dart out the window and hit one. Which is exactly what the girls did next. Fate would have to be on the girls' side today. And as luck would have it, Madame Argentina and Fred were passing that exact location as the dart was just about to hit.
What? Again?
Yeah!
Having heard their dart hit its random target, the girls flew to investigate. But unfortunately, by the time they got there, Madame Argentina had already darted off.
Look what I found!
What is it?
A tarot card! Girls, this is worse than we imagined.
Whatever do you mean, Blossom?
Not only are we dealing with a petty criminal, we're dealing with a terrorist.
Look, more cards.
Yes, it's true. In Madame Argentina's hasty getaway, she inadvertently left a tarot trail leading directly to her new location.
Let's go get her.
Yeah, I see a knuckle sandwich in her future.
No, wait. I've got a better idea. You ready, Buttercup?
Check.
You ready, Bubbles?
Ready.
Ready.
Great. Let's put Operation Over Medium into action.
With their superpower of disguise, the girls were able to saunter into Madame Argentina's tent like a normal everyday citizen.
Oh, good day, kind sir. I've been expecting you.
Wow, she is good.
Shh, hurry.
So tell me, what will it be today? Would you like your palms red?
Oh, no, thanks. I like them the color they are.
Bubbles?
I mean, of course. Why else would I be here in your oh-so-legitimate place of business?
Oh, well then, please sit.
Which the girls did. And as Madame Argentina plied her false fortunes, the goose got down.
Is that a feather joke?
But when Fred stuck his head in the pocket, he didn't find a wallet, nor did he find jewelry. He found a buttercup.
The Powerpuffs! Oh, let's get out of here!
Now that the jig was up and the Powerpuff Girls were firmly entrenched in their own disguise, Madame Argentina and Fred were able to sneak out the back, where they escaped aboard her astral plane. Having finally freed themselves, the Powerpuff Girls were not far behind and trailed Madame Argentina to Voodoo Island, also known as the Isle of Trouble. Once there, Madame Argentina made her way directly to the local neighborhood voodoo shop.
Yes, give me 3 Powerpuff dolls, a box of pins, and throw in a box of gumdrops.
That'll be $20, please.
Keep the change.
Meanwhile...
Look, there she is!
And she's got dolls of us!
And a box of pins!
What in the world would she want those things for?
And with the first poke of the pin, the girls quickly got the point.
Ouch!
Go on my tailbone!
Plunging hopelessly out of control, the girls hurtle towards Earth and crash into some nearby bushes. Dissatisfied with the drop she got on the girls, Madame Argentina quickly tied up her dolls and hung them from a tree branch over the edge of a cliff, which of course left the Powerpuff Girls dangling in midair as well. With the girls out of the way, Madame Argentina was able to return to Townsville and continue her reign of terror. And the newspapers this day read, Powerpuffs powerless to pinch, pocket-picking, pin-pushing predictor. Will the girls ever escape this literal cliffhanger? Will the mayor ever get back into Townsville? Will Madame Argentina ever share her gumdrops? Find out in the next exciting chapter called Hoodoo Voodoo or Don't Scry for Me, Argentina.
And now, a word from our sponsor.
Eating pickles again, Mayor?
I can't help it, Miss Cerebellum. I'm addicted. That's what I am.
Then you should try the Pickle Patch.
The what?
The Pickle Patch and go cold turkey.
That is a splendid idea, Miss Cerebellum. You were right, Miss Bellum. The Pickle Patch is great, especially on cold turkey sandwiches.
Oh, Mayor.
The Pickle Patch, when you want to quit eating pickles, or when you don't.
When we last left the action, a short psychic and her goose were heading back to Townsville to pick the pockets of its unwitting citizens. Meanwhile, our heroes were in a predicament of their own. Madame Argentina left three voodoo dolls of the girls tied up and hanging from a tree branch, which of course left the real Powerpuff Girls dangling precariously over the edge of a cliff. But fortunately for the girls, the demand for Powerpuff Girl merchandise was at an all-time high, and the three dolls were quickly snatched up by an avid collector and promptly put up for auction on eBay.
Now, let's go get that turkey and her goose.
No, I've got a better idea. One Fred-shaped voodoo doll, please.
That'll be $5, please.
Keep the change.
And with that, the girls left Voodoo Island to put their plan into action.
I sure love barbecue goose.
Yeah, me too.
Save the neck for me.
As luck would have it, Madame Argentina was flying directly overhead and noticed a peculiar scene. Looking through her horoscope, she saw...
Yikes! Fred!
Sensing that her goose was about to be cooked, Madame Argentina turned her plane around and headed in. And with great determination, she put the plane into a nosedive, but crashed into the ground, flinging them from the plane directly into the barbecue, where the lid was put on this case for good. And so the recovered goods were returned to their rightful owners.
Yay!
And the mayor was let back into Townsville faster than you could say, open sesame.
Open sesame.
There you go, Mayor.
Shoot!
Charred and behind bars, Madame Argentina and Fred will no longer be picking pockets. And the newspapers read this day, it's rare to see a medium so well done. And so the day is saved, thanks to the Powerpuff Grill.
Treasure awaits!
Smash! Smash! treasure of Captain Flynn. The treasure must still be in that structure. We go back and search again.
Captain, look at the bird! There was a door there when I left.
Oh! Huh? Have a nice rest, you scurvy dog!
What? Pirates?
How observant of you, landlubber! Now, where did you hide the treasure of Captain Flynn?
I don't have any treasure.
Our map led us to your home. But all we be finding is your stash of refreshments. And mighty fine refreshments they be, but not the treasure we seek.
You drank all of it.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, boy.
So where is it? I'll be having that treasure, or I be not Captain Crack McCragan.
Captain Crack McCragan? You mean the Captain Crack McCragan? The famous Captain Crack McCragan and the crew of the Black Watch? The wildest bunch of buccaneers ever to sail the seven seas?
Aye, that we are.
Fascinating. But you disappeared hundreds of years ago.
We didn't disappear. We be right here.
Rumor had it that you got caught in the fabled Townsville Bay vortex just off the coast. It must have catapulted you into the future, which is incredible. I even did my college thesis on it. Much to the ridicule of my peers, I discovered that it always appears in twos, which means that it should show itself again soon, providing an opportunity to travel back to your own time. You know, I'm a scientist. I can help.
Do you have the treasure?
No.
Do you know where a big tree is?
No.
You're walking the plank!
Oh!
What the heck happened? The place is a mess!
Oh no! Look!
Oh no! Someone's kidnapped the professor!
I wonder if that flying pirate ship I saw in town had anything to do with it.
You saw a flying pirate ship? Why didn't you say something?
We see weird stuff all the time!
True that. I don't know what flying pirate villains want with the professor, but we're gonna find them and make them pay!
Guys, is this really necessary?
Aye! No, quit stalling, you yellow belly!
Oh, boy.
Walk!
How hard can it be to find a flying pirate ship in the middle of a...
Ow! That hurt!
Guess we found the ship. Now to find the professor. Professor!
Wow. Thanks, girls. There's no time to lose. We gotta go back to the ship. Keep them busy. I have a plan.
Lucky shot, bub.
doing great, girls! Keep them at bay just a bit longer!
We can't defeat these guys! They're as strong as us!
Hold on, girls!
How much longer?
Should be any time now! The pirates drank a huge quantity of Chemical X and became supercharged, but it's been designed to work with other ingredients to provide balancing components to the power-yielding quantity embedded. Therefore, when pure strain Chemical X is overloaded into any given subject, it lacks the absorbing factors necessary to render powers given to said subject permanently, thereby creating a limiting element to the duration of powers received, with appropriate backlash and diminishing returns.
In English?
They had too much Chemical X, the powers have worn off, now they're really tired.
Oh! So what now?
Send them back where they came from.
How?
Well, when the Townsville Vortex opened up and sent them into the future, it operated on a multi-level quadrilateral fluctuating dimension that is vertically integrated with oscillating plasmatic shifts. The shifts reverberate through dimensional space, which then bounce off negative matter, resulting in metaphysical and interdimensional splash echo, causing a replicating event horizon in the ethereal plane, spreading horizontally back to the median originating incident.
Professor!
The vortex repeats itself, so we put them back in it.
All right!
Hurry, girls! We haven't much time!
Aye, aye, Captain!
Aye. Can you keep it down? I got a headache.
Far she blows! Good job, girls. Let's go. A lot has changed since this map was made.
Yeah, that tree could be any tree in Townsville.
I bet the treasure was never found.
Well, I look positively piratical. Boy, I thought I'd never find a use for this old chest full of shiny stuff I dug up in my yard. Oh, there's seven seas and one of me. Yo-ho-ho, in a bottle of pickles. Yo-ho-ho, hee-hee-hee.
And so, once again, the day is saved, thanks to the Pirate Pop Girls. Yo-ho, yo-ho, it's a Power Pop's life for me. Sugar, spice, and everything nice. These were the ingredients chosen to create the perfect little girl. But Professor Utonium accidentally added an extra ingredient to the concoction, Chemical X. Thus, the Powerpuff Girls were born! Using their ultra superpowers, Blossom, Bubbles, and Buttercup have dedicated their lives to fighting crime and the forces of evil! The City of
No! No! I give up! I'm too frustrated!
Takes care of that! Boy, I'm hungry.
meet the professor for dinner. Hurry up, you guys! Yeah, this is great! All you can eat, how I love it! There she goes again, Miss Overdo It. What's that supposed to mean? Oh, nothing.
Here are your fortune cookies.
Yay!
One for you. And one for you. And one for you.
What's your fortune, Bubbles?
You bring sunshine to all who surround you.
I do!
What's yours?
Your quality is that of a leader. Others are sure to follow you.
That's true!
What's yours, Buttercup?
Be not violent or angry. Peace lies within.
What a stupid fortune. It wasn't even funny.
I don't know, Buttercup.
Sounds right to me.
Me too.
What?
I'm just saying you should take it to heart.
You have been taking your fighting a little too far lately.
Yeah. You didn't have to beat the stuffing out of Fuzzy so badly.
Poor Fuzzy.
Hello! He's a stinking bad guy, remember? He deserves it!
He gave up! It was over! But you continued to beat him up anyway.
It was a bit much.
You just don't know when to stop. You're always overdoing it.
I'm the good guy!
Oh, no, you're not.
Oh, Fuzzy!
Are you proud of yourself, young lady? Thanks to you, he can't eat right, he can't talk right, he can't even think right!
But I... No! No! No!
What got into her?
Those jerks! It's not like how they say. I'm just doing my job. I'm just... Ah, who am I kidding? They're right. I'm a mess. I need to change, and I don't even know where to start.
At the beginning, Grasshopper.
What the... Who? I'm not a grasshopper.
Knowing the problem is the first step in solving it. I can guide you, but the journey is yours alone to take.
You don't even know what my problem is. How can you...
Grasshopper, be not violent or angry, for peace lies within.
Yeah, I get that a lot.
I think this was yours.
My fortune from the cookie, but how did...
To conquer oneself is a greater victory than to conquer thousands in battle. You need patience, Grasshopper, and wisdom.
Wait! So cool! Wait for me!
The path will not be easy.
I'm ready.
Only the most serious mind can...
That's me!
You must look inward.
Get on with it!
You must be patient, Grasshopper.
Oh, sorry.
You must let go.
I'm ready, teacher.
Good. We begin. This is going to take a while. Fire Beetle.
Yes, it is I. The prodigal monkey returns, for I left but the student, but I must be the master. So I have returned to be the master, for I am no longer the student. And to be the master, I must defeat the master, and then I will be the master and no longer a student. For you were supposed to teach me, but you could not because you are crazy, so I have taught myself. Now this monkey returns to destroy you and elevate my status to master. How do you like them apples, fancy pants?
You came seeking only violence. You were impatient. You would not look inside yourself. I could only guide you. The journey was yours to make. I did not fail you nor the teachings. You failed yourself. And another thing, you're not a monkey, you're a chimp. There's a difference.
Your double talk no longer works on me, for I am the master, which I shall now prove without further delay. So prepare yourself for a whoopin'. Hold the phone. A Powerpuff Girl?
She is my new student, and most accomplished. She has done what you could not. She has calmed herself.
Her? You crazy teacher man! She is the most violent and ill-tempered of all the Powerpuffs! The most easily enraged, reveling in destruction, anger, overkill, and... I show you. Girls are stupid. I'm smarter than you. You cannot defeat me. Green is not your color. You look fat in that dress. No matter. Enough time wasting. Oh, this is so frustrating. Your shoes are tight. Sucker monkey punch!
What should I do, Master?
The water rushing down the mountainside washes away impurities and replenishes the land. You must be like water, Grasshopper.
What?
Kick his butt!
Oh no! Wait, I take it all back! I didn't mean it!
Yeah! High five! Woohoo! Oh, yeah. Sorry.
Grasshopper, a skilled warrior strikes a decisive blow, then stops. Be not boastful or arrogant. Strike out of necessity. Take no delight in the defeat of others.
Yes, Master.
You have done well, Grasshopper. Fighting evil is your purpose, but remember, all things in moderation. Now, it is time to rejoin your sisters.
Thank you, Master.
She's a good kid.
Wow, it's a whole new Buttercup! Who says a grasshopper can't be a butt-kicker? And so, once again, the day is saved, thanks to the Powerpuff Girls! The City of Townsville! Where all are sleeping peacefully. Wait a minute, I take that back.
Yeah, well, no, no, please, stop.
I'm coming!
Oh, Professor! It's terrible! You and the Powerpuff Girls, you gotta help me!
Now, now, Mayor, why don't you start from the beginning? Oh, girls!
Sire Z, it's the same terrible, horrible dream every night! and I always wake up before I can
resolve.
Can't resolve the ending. I can't resolve it.
Mayor, we fly around Townsville, remember? Da-da-da-da-da-da. And we fight crime in the real world. That doesn't mean we have the power to do so in the dream world.
No. Yes?
No! We're going back to bed.
Girls, wait. Actually, there is a way we can help the mayor. Now, this special headpiece, when connected to the Nocturnatron, will allow the girls, while sleeping, to enter into your dream and find out what's going wrong.
Yeah. Get on with it so we can get back to sleep.
Now, everyone relax and breathe deeply. Yes, relax. Good.
File for the city council. Make sure Mayor gets it by 5 p.m.
Okay, great. Okay, I'm on it.
Mayor's office. I'm sorry, he's in a meeting. Please hold. Yes, Mr. Mayor. I'll send them in right away, sir. Girls, the mayor will see you now.
See you at 8 then. All right. Ta-ta, my little gherkin. Yes?
The City Emergency Finance Committee, line one.
Thank you. Yes? Yes? Bankrupt, is that so? That's a tough one. Let me think about it and get back to you. Okay. Simply roll over the city's tax-sheltered annuities to small-growth mutual funds, adjust the GPG status accordingly, conduct a sweeping inquiry that will root out and dispose of corrupt city officials, resulting in a substantial tax reduction for the people. Then, with the leftover funds, make a fully tax-deductible donation to the Home for the Elderly, Minorities, and War Veterans. Capital, sure, anytime, think nothing of it. Ah, Powerpuff Girls. So good of you to come. Why, I've forgotten how adorable you really are. Aren't you girls supposed to be in school?
Well, yes, but we're like in a dream.
Yes, aren't we all? Education is important, girls. Important.
Right. But the reason we're here is to...
Get an education and the world will be yours. Take a look out there, girls. What do you see?
Everything's made of pickles?
Wrong. What you see is potential. Girls, someday all of this will be mine. Tut, 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 not another word. We'll discuss it over lunch. Miss Bellum!
Yes, Mayor?
Book a lunch for four at that little German place.
Yes, Mayor.
You like pickles, don't you, girls?
Hi, Mayor! We love you, Mayor!
Good day to you! Cheerio! Yes, I love the flavor of this city. It has... Excuse me. As I was saying, I love this town. You see, it's not the love that sustains commitment.
Oh my gosh, it's the mayor! Hi, Mr. Mayor!
My friend thinks you're totally hot!
Shh! We're going to Bill and Jess to get some ice cream. Wanna come with us?
Not today, girls. I'm on a straight pickle diet. Have to watch this girlish figure of mine. You stay out of trouble, okay?
I want to marry him. Come on, girls!
I'll handle this.
Again, the day is saved. Thanks to the Powerpuff Girls.